Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Jodi. I'm a hairstylist based in Nairobi. I mostly offer creative hairstyling, personal hairstyling, basically just everything that has to do with hair. You know, I do that. So if you want to contact me for my services, just head over to Instagram and search Hair by Jodi, or there's a link on the description down below. So yeah. If you need my services, just contact me there. So today's video, we're going to do the ponytail link. The picture is just up here. Yeah, we're gonna do that video. I wanna show you guys how I did the ponytail link, because most of you have been requesting me to do that on Instagram, and I've been quite a bit lazy when it comes to that, but I got a client yesterday and she requested for that ponytail. So I saw that as a good opportunity to record for YouTube. So let me not talk too much. So let's get right into the video. And also make sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you're new to the channel. And let me know down below in the comment section if you liked the video, if there's anything or any improvement that you need me to make in my videos. So yeah, thank you. Let's get right into the video. Bye. So you're gonna need the rings for the ponytails. I got this from House of Leather. They were like, I think 800. Yeah, one, the huge one was 800 and the tiny one was 400. I could have used styrofoams, but then I didn't have them, and if I was to use styrofoams, I had to import them, and I didn't have enough time to do that. So we had to work with whatever it is that we had. And then also you're going to need some braiding hair. I used the Darling color number one hair. Yes. And then also you're going to need some bonding glue. Yes, I used this specific one. That one. Oh, here I was just trying to confirm if it was focusing. And then you're also gonna need a rat tail comb and some scissors. So here basically I was just brushing the hair itself, because it really tangles up. I don't know why, but it really tangles up. I didn't apply some oil to it because I didn't want it to repel against the glue. Oh, and just there you can see my brother was laying on the couch. So yeah, here I was brushing the hair and making sure that it's as straight as possible, so it's not really difficult to like just lay it down on the ring itself, as you're gonna see on the video when we start. So now I pulled out the rings. This is how they look like. They're actually toys for kids, but I didn't know what to use. Since for shipping, like, it was going to take 2 weeks for them to ship the hair. Ship the styrofoams. So, yeah, I had to use what I could get. So, here, basically, I was just separating the hair that I wanted to use for the fast rings. And the rings that I got, they go from the biggest size to the smallest size. So I started off with a small piece of hair. You don't want to have a huge section. It's difficult to manage it when you're using huge amount of hairs. So just take small sections. And then here I was just spreading the glue on the rings itself. So I'm going to explain later on how you're going to loop the rings. So basically here I was just trying to apply the glue, and you want to make sure that when you're applying the glue, you don't put too much glue, because it really sticks faster. Not even necessarily sticks faster, but it's difficult to deal with it, because you'll be spreading glue all over the place and it's going to touch your hands, and your hands are going to stick on the hair. Yeah, it's difficult to deal with synthetic hair. So here I was just trying to make the hair go round. So I would pull the hair on the ring on the inside and just make it go round the ring. Yes, over and over again. It's really a difficult process to do this, but you really need a lot of patience for you to achieve this style. Thank you. And voila, this is how it looks like after I was done putting the hair on the rings. Yep, you can see how good it looks. So, oh, sorry, this is my nephew trying to help. So I went ahead and did the rest of the rings on a time-lapse video. I'm going to come back when I'm done doing all the rings. I did 10 rings. So yeah, see you as soon as I'm done with the rings. I did a total of 10 rings. As you can see, I left some of the spaces on the rings so that it's going to be able... You'll see in the video how I'm going to interloop the rings. So I would take the ring, like the first ring, and here I was just cutting that section where I would loop it to the other ring. So you want to cut it this way. Yeah. And then take now the second ring and then put it, yeah, just like that. Yes, just like that. And then take the third ring and cut it. And then do the same process again, put it on the second ring. So I will show you how you will be able to hide the colored part, but that video I will show you when I'm actually installing the hair on the client. So when you loop the ring, you want to make sure that the first one, you don't cut the first one, you cut the second one. You don't cut the third one, you cut the fourth one. I don't know if it's making any sense, but yes, you want to make sure that you don't cut all the rings. It's going to be difficult to hide the parts that you've cut, because the lower you go, the smaller the rings will be. So that makes it more difficult for you to put the hair or pull the hair inside the ring and out the ring. So we're on to the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're on the sixth one. So yeah, this is the sixth one. And the lower you go, just like I said, the lower you go, the harder it's going to be putting the rings. So the last few rings, we're not gonna interlink them. We're going to sew them. Just, you'll see in the video. So here I was trying to hide some of the colored, the places that I had cut. So I put some glue and then I take the hair and just make it go around that section where it's cut, just like that. It's really difficult. It's very tedious. You really need, just like I said, you really need a lot of patience to do this. Yep. For this section, I used a lot of glue because I want the place to be fixed. You don't want it to be coming off when it's on the client's head, or maybe, like, for example, if you're doing the hair for an event, you don't want some of the rings to, like, come off and just, that would be so embarrassing. So you have to make sure that, but this, for this specific rings, we were doing it for a shoot. Yes, it was just for a shit. After you've secured all the hairs on the ending section of the rings, you want to take the ring and just twist and turn it and make sure that the part where you put the cut, it's hidden where the links, where the rings are interlooping, so that it's not really visible. So we're going to make sure that the flyaways are completely gone. I'm going to use a blow dry to do that later on in the video. So after I was done with this part, I went to the shooting location, and this is me slicking down the client's hair. I'll also do a video, another video. If you guys want me to do a video of how I normally like slick my client's hair, just let me know down below in the comment section. But this video is about how you can do the interlinking ponytail. So I'll do another video on how I slick down the hair. So I'm going to fast forward the process. So we did a high ponytail. Well, it's not really that high, but we're going to make it look like it's high by when. So here I was just sewing down her hair just to give it that shape. And then I didn't put the entire ring. So I started first off with the first ring, because it's really difficult to sew down when the entire ring is. It's not really heavy per se, but it's difficult for me to do it when the rings are like linked together. So first, normally I would start off with the first link and then just put the other ones later on. So I braided it down a piece on the first ring, and then now I'm going to use that braided hair to just sew down into her hair, just to give it that foundation. Yes, just to give it that foundation where, like, we're going to put the accessory and all that. Yeah, so that's what I was doing. And then I'm going to come back when I have set down the foundation properly. Thank you.
So after I was done setting the foundation, I went ahead and took the rest of the rings and interlooped them. And here I was just trying to hide all the colors, the purple color from the second ring. Because I remember I had previously done all the rings and linked them when I was still in the house. So I didn't link the first one to the rest of the ponytails. So it was going to be easy. It was not going to take a lot of time to install it. So after I was done putting the hairs on the ring, I went ahead and took a blow dry and just blow dried all the flyaways out of the hair.
You want to make sure that you've sewed it down properly to just give it that foundation. Since the client is going to be making a lot of movements, you want to make sure that it doesn't come off. And I went ahead and put in that gold accessory just to complement the look. And I'm going to show you the final look of how it came out. And so far, I'm so happy with the outcome. It really looked great on her. The client loved it, and thank you guys. If you're still here right now, thank you for watching my video. Let me know down below in the comment section if you liked the video, or let me know below if there are any questions that you have about the ponytails. And if you're in Nairobi, then if you need my services, please make sure to do contact me from my Instagram. My Instagram handles is hairbyjody1 or Victor Mulewa. So in case you wanna hire me for the ponytail for a shoot maybe or for an event, just contact me. So yeah guys, this is the final look. Thank you for watching, and let me show you how it looks like after.